स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स बिगिन विद द थर्ड चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर इकोनॉमिक्स बुक ऑफ ग्रेड 12 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज थियोरी ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी एंड इंडिफरेंस कर्व एनालिसिस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द यूटिलिटी पार्ट एंड इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंडिफरेंस कर्व एनालिसिस. सो इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव केम अक्रॉस अबाउट द cardinal utility analysis and the ordinal utility analysis. Here it's a further discussion not only about the cardinal utility analysis, they are saying about the marginal utility and total utility also. So meaning of utility, this is the first thing we need to understand, what is the meaning of utility. But before that I would like to just give you a recap of the cardinal utility. Cardinal utility are the utility by measuring, we are measuring the utility in terms of the cardinal numbers. Cardinal numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All these are the cardinal numbers. And ordinal utilities are those utilities when we are measuring it in terms of first, second, third, fourth. We are ranking the utility, okay? This is the thing we understood in the previous chapter. Meaning of utility. Utility refers to the want, satisfying power of the commodity. As we are consuming or using the commodity, the satisfying we are getting, the satisfying power of that commodity, the more we are getting satisfied using that commodity, okay? The power of that satisfaction is called utility of that commodity. Utility can be defined as the amount of satisfaction derived from the consumption of a commodity. Utility is subjective. This means utility cannot be fixed in its nature. Okay? It is subjective. It is a psychological matter. From person to person, it is going to differ. Utility is not measurable. Utility cannot be measured. According to some economists, they are saying utility cannot be measured, and some are saying it can be ranked in units, or often these units are called utils, UTILS, utils. Third is utility is relative in nature. Utility is relative in nature means from person to person, the person, same person may be using the same commodity at different time, that person is getting different level of satisfaction. We can take an example of an ice cream, okay? As they are having ice cream in the summer season and having the same ice cream, the same person is having in the winter season. Okay, the utility is changing according to the time. Next, we are having utility is different from usefulness. We must understand this. The things which are having utility doesn't mean that it will be useful. It can be harmful also. For example, we can say poisons, drugs. Okay, then cigarettes, then alcohol. All these are having utility. The person who is consuming this kind of harmful commodities, that person is feeling the utility of it. But actually, morally, if we see, is those products actually very useful for us? No, those are very harmful. But then also that product is having utility. Okay, devote the ethical connections. Utility has no ethical or moral connections, okay? It is not related to any morality, like product is good, product is bad, it is causing harm to people. They are just measuring the utility, how much it is satisfying the person who is consuming it, okay? Next, we are having total utility. You can see in the diagram a tabular representation of utility schedule for mangoes is given, table 3.1, page number 32. You can see total units. What are the units of mango? Means number of mangoes they are consuming. First is 0, then is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Total utility they are measuring. So as the person had, you can say 6 mangoes, the person is saying that the its sixth one is having the marginal, the total utility of 19. You can see the total utility first increasing and then decreasing, right? Similar to the marginal utility, you can see. So if we say a consumer have consumed one mango, what is the utility? 10. When the consumer consumed two mangoes, he is having utility 17. when he consumed 3 mangoes, he is having total utility of 21. As he consumed 4 mangoes, he is saying the utility is 22. As he consumed the 5th mango, he is saying he is having the utility, total utility is 22. As he consumed total 6 mangoes, he is saying the utility is 19. Total utility means when the total, all the things of that commodity have been consumed, what is the total utility? So here we can say the total utility of 6 mangoes is 19. What is marginal utility then? Marginal utility means with addition of every unit of consumption, means with the addition of every unit of the commodity, the utility we get. As we were saying here, in the total utility, he have consumed 2 mangoes, 3 mangoes, 4 mangoes. No, we are not going to say for the marginal utility. For marginal utility, we are going to say first mango. In the first mango, he got the utility of 10. In the second mango, we are not consuming 2 mangoes. We are saying in the second mango, he got the unit of 7. The marginal utility of the second one is 7. The marginal utility of the third mango is 4. The marginal utility of fourth mango is 1. The marginal utility of fifth mango is 0. And the marginal utility of sixth one is -3. This means we can understand as the person is consuming more and more of the same commodity, the utility is decreasing. And you can see after the fifth one became 0 and the sixth one went to the negative point. Now the person doesn't want to have that mango anymore. Okay, this is what have been explained here. So as we consume more of a commodity, we can say the utility keeps on diminishing or keeps on decreasing. What is the relationship between total utility and marginal utility have been described here. Now you can see in the diagram given, page number 33, what is the total utility. You can see total utility, the same thing which we have studied just now in our utility schedule, the same thing have been drawn in curve form. Okay, so the total utility, you can see from 0 point, the first diagram I'm talking about, the total utility curve, yeah, this one. Okay, it is increasing from 0. You can see it is slowly and steadily it is increasing. As a person is having more of it, it is slowly and slowly it is increasing, and it is going to a certain level where it is coming static, and after that it is diminishing, it is bending downwards. So you can see it is coming up, coming to a static position, and again bending downward. In the second one, we can say in the second diagram given just at the below, you can see the marginal utility. First of all, the marginal utility, when the person was having the first mango, you can see the utility is going up. As he consumed the second one, is coming down, the third one more down, and we are getting a downward sloping curve. And later on, you can see after the fifth point, the curve have went down below the axis, right? We can see it's coming below the axis. That means it have went to the minus point. Okay, so more and more we will have the same thing, the utility of that commodity is decreasing. This is the thing which is explained in your next page with law of diminishing marginal utility. This is itself called law of diminishing marginal utility, which means as we keep on consuming more and more of the same commodity, the utility decreases. Okay, next we are having consumer's equilibrium through cardinal utility approach, one commodity case. Okay, here in your book they have took the case of only one single commodity, and what is a consumer's equilibrium. First of all, let me explain it to you in a very simple term. What is the meaning of consumer's equilibrium? Here, first of all, get this thing clear in your head, that equilibrium means where at a given price level the consumer is ready to consume. Okay, at a given price level, the commodity, the quantity the person is ready to consume, where the demand and the price is meeting at a point, where the demand and the price is meeting at a point, and the supplier is ready to supply or the seller is ready to sell. there and the consumer is also ready to buy at that given quantity and the given price. Where these two things will meet together, where they are intersecting each other, there you can say that intersecting point is called equilibrium. Okay, so let us start. Here you can see a diagram is given in page number 37. Here they have took example of a shirt. Okay, a shirt. Where they are saying, you can see the x-axis is telling us about the marginal utility. Okay, and the y-axis is telling us about the marginal utility, and the x-axis is telling us about the number of shirts. Here they have consumed that the price of that commodity is fixed to ₹600. The price of the shirt is fixed to 600. Okay, and here we can see the shirt, the person can buy a shirt of 700. From here the consumer's equilibrium, you can say the marginal utility curve is starting from right at the top. Out of 700, from 700 the person can buy a shirt, 650 the person can buy a shirt, 600 also the person can buy a shirt, out of 500 also the person can buy a shirt, and 350 a person can buy a shirt. You can see all the points when we are joining together, we are getting a downward sloping curve. Okay, you can see the x-axis 1, at the top of 1 and 700 there is 1 point. At the top of 2, at the top of the second, you can see there is 650. From that way, if we join, we are getting a marginal utility. The marginal utility, as I have explained you just now, the marginal utility always keeps on diminishing. Okay, so that's why we are getting a downward sloping curve. But can you see the point where it is intersecting each other? Yes, at this point, you can see it is intersecting each other. At the point E, right? Where the line is 600 drawn, the P is the price. The price is 600 and the marginal utility at 600 is intersecting each other. Where they're intersecting, that is the equilibrium. That means out of 600, the person will buy, you can say, the third shirt the person will buy, because the person will see that the third shirt quality, or you can say the third shirt price, is suiting his marginal utility. One shirt costing him 700 is above his budget, or you can say is not giving him that much of utility. For that, as he is buying the third shirt for 600, he is getting maximum utility from that given money. So he is feeling like 600 is okay for a shirt. So that is the point where he will buy the commodity. The same thing have been explained with a, you can see, tabular representation given in your 3.3 table. Hope you understood the chapter. We shall continue from page number 38, Law of Equi-Marginal Utility. Thank you.